Welcome to episode 12 of the Nitty Digit Podcast. My name is Jay. I am your host. If you are new, thank you for coming on by and checking me out. Grab a seat. Enjoy the ride. If you're returning again, thank you so much for coming back every week and seeing me blabber on about knitting and nails and books. Anyway, let's get started with what is off my needles. Now, I promised that this would be off the needles, and it is. So let me show it to you. Here you go. I'm hiding. So these, again, for those who haven't been watching, these are the Pointelle socks by Cookie 8 in her Knit Sock Love Book. It's done in Lisa Souza sock merino, which is, I believe, 100% super fine merino wool. This was a mirrored pattern, so this is the left. Yes, this is the left. Now I can't. This is the left. This is the right. So, they turn out really well. Very happy with it. Only one mistake that I'm not going to point it out because I don't want to. So, and these were done in the size US 1 needles, 2.25 millimeter. And I believe those were my Hiya sharps. And I love my Hiya. So here you go. And again, as I always do, I usually wear them immediately when I finish them to kind of see how they work and how they feel, and they're perfect. Fabulous. So there they are. All right. So these were the last of my Cookie A patterns. I love Cookie A. Love her to death. Love her patterns. But I think I've done a lot of them that I'm kind of burnt out. So I'm going to take a little break from Cookie. So because I did a lot of casting off the past few weeks, I've done a lot of casting on. So let me start with my parade of projects for you. But first let's show you what I'm still working on, and I've been working on for a while, which is my Elizabeth Zimmerman's pie shawl. Basic pie shawl. And the last time I had just started the creamy yellowy white, and I'm still at the white. So I'm kind of doing this as I go, you know. Let me see if I can do it how I did it last time, which is kind of see how it's going to be if I don't lose stitches. So the one thing I found with the Blue Moon, so the white, the creamy yellowy white is Silky Socks at Rock in Blue Moon Fiber Arts Spirits colorway, called Marais. And I'm finding that with this silk, it comes off the needles it's very slippery, I guess is the better term. So I've been losing a lot of stitches with this. Thankfully have been able to fix it, but I have to be very careful about stretching it and whatnot. So, yeah. You can't really see the white, but I would say I'm 75% done. I'm going to do another 10 rows on the creamy, yellowy, on the silky socks that rock. And then I'm going to do about 10 rows and then the cuff. Not the cuff. See, I've been knitting so many socks. And the border with the gray. And then I think I'm going to use these two yarns together again for a hat, because in the winter when I'm walking to work, walking to BART and then to work, my ears get cold. So I think I need more hats. So, like a nice little beret. Anyway, so that is my pie shawl. And I've been carrying around in my purse as my commuter project, but I think I'm gonna have to relegate it back to the house because it was just way too heavy in my purse, and I was starting to get, you know how when, if you put your purse, you know, across your body, and if you have too much of it, your muscles, well, at least my muscles do that, so it was hurting, so, and I created a huge knot. So I've decided that it's gonna have to go back into the house and will be my mindless knitting, so, which is fine. I mean, I think that was one of the reasons why I kept losing stitches, because I was trying to knit standing up while waiting for the train, or, you know, or if I couldn't find a seat, I was, you know, I'm very stubborn and I refuse to not knit. So, I kept losing stitches because it was starting to hang, yeah. So, meh, no. It's gonna have to stay home where I'll be happy. So, alright. So now on to my others. So I'm still not done knitting socks. I don't think, as I said, I'll never be not done. I'll never be completely done with knitting socks because I love knitted socks. So, and again, I set up my queue so that way I'm trying to use up all my old 2 to 3 year old stash. So, which I guess I could enter into the Knit Girl stash dash, but I don't know, that would be too much pressure. And I'm a person that if there's too much pressure, I just, meh, I won't deal with it. So, anyway. So here's the first sock that I cast on. And now it's caught on. Oh. So this, I'm doing toe up, I know. So we're breaking into the toe up patterns now. It's awesome. So this is the traditional Gansey sock by Wendy Johnson. It's in her Socks from the Toe Up book. Just a traditional. Very nice. I love the yarn. So the yarn is Lisa Souza. In her BFL sock. The color is The Shore. And I don't see it in, let's see if you can see it on the side. Yeah, okay. So if you can see the orangey speck right around here, or here, or here, you know, that, it's speckled. So it's not just a white and light blue, it's speckles. It's beautiful. It's like, the speckles are supposed to represent the sand. So, yeah, it's not, well, here, maybe this will help. So, it's knitting up really, maybe you can see the back. So, I forgot how much I like toe up. So, I am both a toe up sock knitter and a cuff down. I do not choose. I can make a joke, but I don't know if people will enjoy my joke. But I like both toe up and cuff down. So I'm a bi-knitterly sock knitter. I made it anyway. So I did a couple rounds of that, and I found this is really great for mindless knitting as well. So it's very simple, just knit in purls and just making sure that you're placing them in the correct area. So, and I'm doing these in my Addi Turbos 1 US 1.5 2.5 millimeter, because again, I don't have enough US ones. This is supposed to be, well, actually it's supposed to be US zeros, but I found the US zeros to be really tight. So I usually do ones. I find US ones to be really good with my feet, and US 1.5 tends to be a little a little bigger, but not that much. So that's why I'm fine with you using the 1.5s. But I'm just hoping, I mean, the pattern is still there, so you can still see the pattern, but it is a little looser. And I checked, it fits my foot so far, so. Yep, so that's the first sock. Oh, and this is my Target bag. I have been using this bag like mad ever since I got it for Christmas. Go friend Sammy for just knowing what to get people. She's a really good gift giver. And so when I try to give her gifts, I try to, you know, I think I'm an okay gift giver, but, you know, because I'm always thoughtful, but she's just spot on. So she's good. Love her face. So what's the second sock? All right. Pirates. I bought this one. This is Erin Lane. This is another Wendy Johnson socks from the toe up. I have not knit much on this one. It's her lace and cable socks from the same book. The socks from the toe up. I think I said that already. But oh well. Since it's cables and lace, my mind was just like, eh. So I was able to cast on to the toe. So this is what I have so far on my lace and cable socks. This is, again, another Lisa Souza. So I'm finally knitting into my Lisa Souza, and I'm very happy about that. I think I said that before with my pointels. This is another BFL. This is another BFL sock in Sky Drama. I wonder if my light... So one of my bulbs went out on my stand, so, which is fine. It decreases the heat. Let me tell you how hot I am now. But I think the colors are not... I mean, I'm noticing bright colors are kind of muted. So, yeah. Sky Drama. I like it. So I'm going to... Ooh, that's dangerous. Cable new. It's too big. I think I'm going to get an actual cable new. But anyway. Yeah. I'm just going to put that away. I want to use a different one. Anyway. So, yeah. It's not much. I was going to do a round before recording, but I got waylaid by my next project that I'm going to show. Yes, I have four active projects on the needles. I don't know what I'm going to do. I had a lot of casting on, and I also wound a lot. I wound a lot of yarn this past week. I wanted to get started, just get through my queue, because I'm actually at the very end of my queue, of my planned queue. The rest of my queue is all the things that I'm like, ooh, 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 ooh. Like I'll watch different podcasts, and I'll really like that pattern, so I'll go and find it and put it on my queue. So that's the rest of my queue, but I'm getting very close to the end of my planned queue. I forget what Dana from Just One More Row set called it, but I planned it out, so I'm getting to the end of it. So I just wanted to wind up all the yarn that I had planned out for the patterns, and I just wanted it. I had that itch. So, well, and I also had to skein up my Friday Studios Hawaii yarn that I talked about, the self-striping. So I decided I needed to do it. You know, it's not too... So because... Well, actually now three podcasters are doing it, but I don't really watch the Penguin. What's her name? Penguin. I don't know. They said it just... I just watched the episodes that people mentioned, but it was Penguin something, which... I like penguins. I should watch another penguin, huh? But anyway. But since Knittables is doing it only for June, but Just One More Row is doing it from June through July, I think I have time. So it's not too much of a deadline. So here's it up, stand up. Ooh, okay. See, I should podcast early. I think yesterday I just didn't, last time I didn't podcast as early. So see that? It's beautiful neon. Well, maybe, oh, you're not seeing the neon pink as much. Yeah. So this morning, I was gonna be all like, yeah, I'm trying something new to spice it up. I'm gonna do two at the same time. It's too fiddly and it didn't work, and I had to actually cut out a good, I would say about a good few inches of yarn. About a yard. So hopefully this doesn't kill my socks, but I think I still have enough, but it was just, I got it so tangled. I figured out how to cast on it. It was going all right. It was a little bit of a pain, but I figured, you know what? It'll be fine. I'll figure it out. And the reason why I started it this morning rather than last night was because last night was still May. So I am a rules person. I follow KALs and all the rules up to the max. Until sometimes I'm like, eh, I don't want to. And I am following a pattern. It's Vanilla Socks by Elizabeth Suarez. I thought it was called My Favorite Vanilla Sock, but I think it's because her company is called My Favorite Heart or something like that. I don't know. But so it's kind of off in the colors because it was supposed to be green. It was supposed to be this green and then the pink and then something else. Oh, sorry. It was supposed to be the lighter green. So see this lighter green? Of course you can't see it because it's on my lap. So you see this lighter green? It was supposed to be that, then the pink, and then the darker green, which let me pull it out. If I can pull it out. Okay. You see at the edges is this dark green? Yeah. So colors are messed up. And it wasn't gonna be twinsies anyway when if I did it two at a time because one started at yellow because I was pulling it out from here for one and then around and it just got too twisted and I'm just not smart enough, I guess, or it was just too fiddly and I guess I didn't have enough coffee. So I would have had more progress. I would have. I'm still on the cuff. I'm gonna finish it at one, so I would say I'm half an inch. So I need another inch. But that's why I don't have much progress on my lace and cable socks or this one. I could have been, with how much time I spent futzing around in the morning, I could have easily gotten good enough progress, but because of the fact that I screwed up and yeah. So, but I started. It's getting there. I thought I was gonna be so cool and have two at a time so that way I could knit two pairs of socks, but meh. I think it would be better if either I had two balls, and kept them separated, or if I had two needles. And just kind of separated them and kind of did that way, but I'll try it out again. But at that point, I was just like, no, it's getting too twisted. I'm getting too. I was cursing, and I am okay with my language, but if I'm like cursing up a storm, that means I'm not happy, and it's not worth the blood pressure, not worth the high blood pressure or the angst to deal with it. And I knit to lower my blood pressure and to be relaxed, not to be fuddly duddly and So, yeah. So this is gonna be my commuter project from now on. I could have been so cool. I could have amazed the masses, right? No, it's okay. They'll just comment on the pretty colors. It's fine. All right. I am now done. I promise you, I'm done. There will be no more projects cast on because I don't think I could handle it. I think I may just power through the pie shell just so I can just not have four projects on my needles, because I think this is the max I've been, and I found that one project kind of lies to the side, just like my lace and cable socks. So, yeah. So, alright, let's go to nails. Now, I'm not going to do book talk today. I want to do some research and some other stuff for an idea I have for book talk. And I also have a review. I don't normally do reviews. Usually with my books, I comment and whatnot. It's not really a review. That's why I call it book talk. But this is an actual review. And then I have some news. But let's first show you what's on my nails. All right. So I was in a Muppet mood, and I haven't. So I bought, when the Muppet line from OPI came out and the Muppet movie came out, I wanted them all. So I got the mini set, and I got maybe two of the full size, Animalistic and then the Fresh Frog of Bel-Air, which you've seen for my St. Patrick's Day manicure. But I haven't used my minis in a while, and I decided I'm going to use my minis. And this actually kind of cured my ADHD. I kept, you know, as I said from last podcast in my picture reel, I then immediately after I changed from my glitter sam my jelly glitter sandwich, I immediately moved to a cream from Julep, and I was just like, oh, I need to stop doing this, because I only have acetone nail polish remover, and I was using the ones where not the bristle. That's why I don't call it what TFIMP calls it, because it's not a true VD. Which, if you want to know what that is, don't look it up on Google. Just go to Ravelry, go to the group TFIMP, join the group. I say join the group, you don't have to, but then go to their page, and they have a dictionary, and you'll find VD in there. Because I'm not going to say it out loud, because I'm a PG. I try to be PG. But anyway, so I've been soaking my nails in that, in the acetone. And I don't have any non-acetone nail polish remover. And I was just noticing that my nails, they were still strong. Well, not, they were better than, they weren't soft. And they weren't weak, like they usually are. But they were getting brittle. I could feel it. I could feel the non-healthiness. So I had to stop doing it. So, I had that on for a few days, and then it died, because I decided to trim my bird's wings, and Maria, Ami is fine. He doesn't bite. I got him to stop biting, and he just screams a lot, and, you know, I was able to do it without as much problems, but with Maria, she loves to bite. I haven't gotten her to not bite me. And I swear, when she uses the stone that's supposed to whittle down the beak, she's doing it in a way that sharpens it. I swear, that bird. I love her, but I swear, that bird. She's sneaky. And so when I was trying to calm her down, I was talking and soothing voices, and she just loves to eat my polish, and she just grabbed right into here and scraped it off. And I was like, fine, whatever, I'm just gonna live with it. It's a chip, it will be a story to tell. But it grew and it grew and it grew, and it just went through all throughout the thumb, and I had peeled it off. And I'm a notorious nail polish peeler, and I was at work, and I didn't have any of my nail polish remover pads, and so I peeled the whole entire thing off. So, and since I'm still trying not to bite my nails, I needed to have polish on it. So I kept going back and forth between nail polish, couldn't figure things out, and I just finally landed on my mutt line. And so I put this, so this is Wonka Wonka. This is part of the mini. I put this on the bottom. And so what I originally wanted to do is I wanted to do a half moon manicure, where the darker was through and then your half moon, like around here, was the white. But I don't have any reinforcers at home, and so I tried using tape. It didn't work. And I, you know, the thing is, I waited forever for that paint to dry, and it felt dry, but once I put tape on it, it's gone. And I was doing what in my head called Jane manicure, because I had just finished Craftlet's Jane Eyre. So, and that's how the reader would say, Jane. So I was using Jane Eyre, my A. England Jane Eyre, and then used Jane from the Real Housewives line from Rescue Beauty Lounge. But it just wasn't working. It wasn't the colors. The colors actually looked amazing, but the user error. So then I finally landed on, again, the Muppet line. So then I put Wonka Wonka on the bottom. Sorry, derailment. Not enough coffee. I'm sorry. So put this on the bottom, Wonka Wonka. And then just only use one coat, because it was actually a very good coverage, and it didn't do it. No bald spots. Very nice. I only needed one coat. And then I put over it Excusez-moi, which is a very glittery, it's a jelly because it's tinted. The glitter, the very fine glitter, is multiple colors: green, pink. I've seen green, pink, white, blue. It's very nice. And then in it, it's a tinted pink. So if you look, it kind of gives it that kind of pinkish. So already Wonka Wonka is a more of a cream red. I would say it's a blue red instead of an orange red. So it's a cream. It's definitely not a jelly. It was first coat, full on opaque. And then this, which it did a very nice job. There you go. So loving it. I've had it on since, so when did I, Tuesday was when Maria ate it. Wednesday was when I peeled it. So from Wednesday night. And I will talk about it further in my review. But it actually didn't last that long. I redid it. And that will be, I will discuss it more in my review. Let me show you the nails. If you can see it. It's shiny and it's glittery and it's so pretty. It's so pretty and I like it. I have been craving blue. But a certain blue. And I've just felt better with red on my nails. And I've been liking the pinks, but it was just getting too, not girly. It's fine to be girly, but I don't know. It just wasn't hitting the right tone. So, yeah, here you go. I love it. Rah. So there you go. You can kind of see. Sorry. When I don't Sometimes my muscles act like I have weird tics. And really, I have not drunk that much coffee, I promise you. Just my muscles are acting weird. It's the fiber. I can't help it. So that's what is on. That is what's on my hands. I need to stop saying and I need to stop blabbering because I have a review and I'm already at 30 minutes in my news, and I don't want people to get annoyed and not hear my big news. So let me start. I am reviewing. So I don't normally do reviews. Let me grab some coffee. As I said, I don't really do reviews as much because I'm still, especially with nail stuff, because I am still learning, and I'm so glad that people are willing to work with me on learning and whatnot, because I'm no expert. I am no expert by any means at all, but I love it that people are willing to hang out with me and learn with me. So but I really wanted to review this because let's just say it's been getting a lot of bad rap. And when I was trying to figure out if I wanted to buy this or not, or actually I bought it. So I bought it by impulse because I thought this was what some people in the TFIMP group were talking about, but I mistaken it for something else. So let me show you what I'm going to review before. So it's Sally Hansen Salon Insta Gel Strips. It's the starter kit. And I bought it in the color Why Not. And if I recorded later in the day, you would know why I do Why Not, because I would be drinking wine, not coffee. I love wine. And I love the color. It was like a very nice deep burgundy. Someone called it purple. I didn't see the purple. I didn't see the purple. I saw more of it as a burgundy, which I guess could be purple and red. Anyway, learning. So I thought someone was talking about this when they were talking about gels, and different. Why am I showing you the French side? Oh my goodness. When there's a thread that they have in regards to gel nails, and I've been going back and forth between doing a DIY home or not, because I'm definitely not going back to the salon to get my nails done, because I just enjoy. I have found that painting my nails is the most relaxing thing ever. And if I'm watching a movie or watching TV on my Kindle, and or listening to podcasts, it's just relaxing. And it's another way of just decompressing from either the day, the week, whatever. It's my spa time. So I was kind of going back and forth because I kind of the one thing I miss is not the thickness of it, because I figured out how to get the thickness. It's the longevity. So the method that I was having putting on my Nailtex 2, which I still love, still I definitely am going to keeping that on my nail for my regular nails. But with the Gelus and SV, the Gelus gave it that wonderful thickness, and the SV gave it that wonderful shine, but it didn't last that long. You had to keep renewing it every other day. And with the Gelus and the and but if you just put the SV, it would shrink. So I had to put the Gelus. So it kept adding layers and layers and layers and layers, and then it would peel off. So it was a good method. I think it's a great method for if you're not doing regular nails. If you're not doing, excuse me, if you are doing regular nail polish, I think it's a great method. I found it to be amazing. and whatnot. But it was the longevity, and it didn't help that I kept just taking nail polish remover and taking it off, and it was so easy. And that was the other thing, is I wondered if the gel would help with my ADHD, maybe help me just put on a nail color and stick with it. And stick with it until it just got grungy and bad, and then it would be a pain. It's not a huge pain, but it's a lot more work to take it off. You have to soak it off. So reading through it, I thought this one person was talking about these. Walgreens had a coupon and it was on sale, and I said, not that bad. I paid, so the average is about $30. I paid $31 something. It's about $30 to $31. If you can get it less money, I would say Target probably has the best price, but I wasn't near Target. I was near Walgreens, and somehow I wanted to scratch that itch, and I did. She was talking about their InstaGel paint, which the only place that carries it is Target, is either Target, but again, not near Target, or Ulta, which again, I'm not, it's about the same areas where Target is. So, I wanted to scratch an itch and I bought this. And when I found out that I was wrong, I'm like, oh, oops. So I decided to read more reviews, and I found reviews to be the most scathing. It was bad, very bad. But then you get pops of positive. So it was kind of like, well, you know, there's always going to be someone that loves it. There could be that one person, or it could be multitudes. And it just, there were a lot more bad reviews that personally were not the greatest reviews, I think, in the sense of they didn't really explain why it didn't work for them. They just said it sucked, the product sucked. I'm like, well, why did it suck? And then you'd have these people who wrote raving reviews that said, you know, you have to follow the instructions to the T, you really have to make sure there's no oils on your hands, it's the best thing ever, the strips make it so much easier. And they even offered additional tips of what worked for them and said, this is one of the things that could help you. So instead of, because I had already opened it, but I had asked someone at Walgreens and they said, even if you open it, you can still return it in within 30 days. So I was going to return it, but then I'm like, you know what? No, I'm going to try it. Well, I did. I tried it out last night. you notice I don't have it on anymore? So, my review is not going to be bad, but it's not going to be good. It's going to be what I've been saying all of today is meh. So, the system itself, let me show you what you get in the kit. So, you get
this cute little LED lamp, which I think is so cute.
So that's kind of a con, is that you don't get the full-on lamp, but again, $30. LED lamps are pretty pricey. So you can only fit one finger in there, but they have a guide of where to put it, which I think is amazing, because when I was doing gels at the salon, there were no guides, and sometimes I wouldn't put it too in because I was afraid of nicking it, or I'd put it too close and I'd nick it. So I like that they give you a guide.
It's so cute!
So a couple of reviewers did say that they had to instantly return it because this broke, and I could see why. So you see how it is? It doesn't really go in. You would think it would go in. So once I put it in, I have not taken it out. I'm too scared of it breaking. So that's one slight con, is it's not too big and it seems to easily break, but it works just fine.
Hello!
So it comes with that. Let's put this here. I don't want to break it. And then it comes with, oh, it comes with cleansing pads. Again, I used it last night, so I don't have them anymore. They're a one-use thing. So you get, here. So I showed you the lamp. You get an emery board, a file. So it comes with the finer grain and the bigger grain. And it comes with the cleansing pads. That's the cleansing pad. And then the nail strips, which are, I have a couple left over, are these. Now, some of the reviews have said, oh, and top coat, which is the most important part. It's a little small, little ball, but it's fine. You still have enough to do more. So, in regards to materials, is actually, other than the cleansing pads and the file and the orange stick, which honestly you shouldn't use multiple times. I mean, and their refills come with that material. Other than, I don't know why they give you another top coat. Maybe because they think you're gonna put tons of it on, even though they say put a thin coat. You know, the refills come with that. It's a little pricey though. It's $15. Walgreens, it was $16. So that's what you get. So, So I did, and I have pictures of my nails after they were done. The process of it, not bad, pretty good. I mean, it was not finicky in the sense of you must do this. It was just have clean fingernails, make sure it's dull so you shape it. So, you know, I think one thing is if your nails are brittle like mine, you should really not use their emery board, their file, because it does take off a good amount. So, I didn't like it as much. I like my crystal file so much better. And honestly, if you do the same thing that they want you to do with your file and your buffer, you're good. And you basically you shape your nail the way you want. So, you know, the method was you push back your cuticles with the orange stick, and then you shape your nails the way you want it, and then you buff it. So it was a three-side file. So it was the heavier grain, the fine grain, and on the other side was a buffer, a white buffer. And you just buff your nails. You just buff it. And one of the reviewers said she even wiped her fingers with nail polish remover, which is a method that a lot of other people do when they're doing regular nail polish. So, so what I did was I put, you know, I removed the nail polish, like also did some of the chip skip that I use, the stuff that really dulls the nails, like the pre-base coat. It's actually really, it really dulled the nail bed really well. So, but then they want you to swipe it with their alcohol swipe. Now, this is the one amazing thing about Sally Hansen is their materials. If you don't want to go out and buy their specific nail cleansing pads, all you need is rubbing alcohol and a cotton swab, or even anything that soaks up the alcohol, and swipe it over. That's all you need. It's just, their cleansing pads are just basically little towels filled with isopropyl alcohol, which is rubbing alcohol. And that, to me, is amazing. I think it's amazing. I think that's, you know, it's speaking to the masses. You know, you don't have to keep buying their cleansing pads if you can't afford it. So you do that. That was the most huge thing that I read through the whole entire thing, and also watched their video, was you had to swipe it with alcohol before you put on the strips. So I did that. I even added the extra step of the chip skip or the pre-base coat. And then I started looking through the strips and figuring out what fits my nails. Now, one of the reviews, and I was glad that I was aware of this, is that a lot of people said that the strips are kind of, they're not, I mean, if you're a beginner and you never use any nail stickers of any sort, you're going to have a little bit of a tough time. I mean, it's the same thing as painting nail polish. You're not going to be, and just like with knitting, you're not going to be an expert from the very beginning. You're going to have to practice, and that's fine. I understood that, and I figured, okay, that at least I know that I would probably not be the only one. But here's then the hiccup. See how wide these are? And this is actually like their medium. So they had different sizes. So I'm going to hopefully get to see if you can read this. Look at the fine print right here. You can. It says, strips fit all nails. Sally, honey, people have baby fingers. Baby fingers. I know that you don't want to get it smaller because you don't really want little girls be doing the same thing. I think little girl nails should be able to be. They should have nail polish on it, but they shouldn't go through the rigors of the gel. That's my personal opinion. Probably put my foot in my mouth. But people have small nail beds. And they have nubbins. By choice. But nubbins. See? Give him my thumb. It's your sperm. So, really, this was like almost all their stickers. They had the pinky one, which actually fit. I was impressed by that. Their pinky fit. But everything else. This is the bigger one. These were the thumbs. Posable thumbs for the win. Really? So, there were some suggestions people had in regards to cutting the stickers. Now, thinking back to, it's kind of coming off. Oh, now, cutting it, but I was thinking like cutting it in half, so I did. I cut one in half. But then, it's shaped a very oval way, so it fits, so it looks nice, right? Yeah, no. Now it's too small. And they said stretching, but you couldn't really stretch it around your nail bed. You had to stick it on your nail and then stretch it over the tip. You couldn't stretch it out so that it could be proportioned to your nail. And some people said they were able to cut it in half and still use it. I'm like, how are you able to do that? Maybe like they stretch out the sticker. Like, so the one thing that a lot of the rave reviewers were saying was that you had to stretch it. You had to definitely warm up your hands and stretch it. But I was just trying to figure out how they stretched it out without, you know, taking off the tackiness. I don't know. So what I ended up doing was I would cut the stickers in half and then overlap them so that you can have that shape. Well, you're gonna get a ridge, right? And I did, I got a ridge. And I wasn't right. And it wasn't perfect. And I went and, you know, I had a ridge. And I have pictures of this. I took pictures of this. Like, once you put the top coat over and cured it, it kind of smoothed it out a little. But, no. No. It wasn't right. And I should have known this because I have baby fingers, and I had that problem when I was buying fake nails, and I would put it on myself because they didn't have enough smaller nails, so I would have to cut some of them, and that's why they never worked. So same thing with this. I wish the reviewers explained really what how they were able to cut them in half, and because they some of them were saying, oh yeah, you can get two manicures out of these instead of one, and I'm like, okay, you're gonna have to show me now because I don't get it. So, but everything else, putting on the top coat, wrapping the free edge, you know, putting it under the mini LED light. And so some people said 30 seconds is just fine and it's timed. You don't have to time it. You just have to turn it on. It turns on and it turns off after 30 seconds. A lot of the rave reviews said you really should put it for 60 seconds. So once it turns off, hit it again. So I did that and it worked just fine. It cured it. It was great. It was fine. It's good. But what finally made me sit down and soak them off was, and I really was trying to push myself to keep it on to show it to you guys today and see if it lasted for 2 weeks, but I knew it wasn't going to because as I was knitting and I was looking at them, already edges were slightly. Because again, I Frankenstein them and put them, and I could see the edge where they were meeting in the middle. I could see that they were kind of lifting up, and it wasn't, you know, a little bit was user error in the sense of I really should have thought better of overlaying them. There was no way I could do it without it looking weird. And also when I was so you're supposed to, with the strip, you're supposed to stretch it and then kind of make a crease under your free edge so you basically wrapped your nails and then kind of cut it out by using the finer grain of the nail file. I was using the larger grain. So that's user error on that. So that's why a lot of it was coming off on the edges and rough. But other than that, sizes do not fit all. It really does not fit all. So that is why I have to kind of, it's kind of a thumbs down, thumbs up, because I like the system itself. Now I can't return it to Walgreens because I used up all the materials. But I'm not as bummed about the money that I spent because now I have the gel top coat and the LED light. So now I can do many things with that. I'm going to explain now. So I use regular nail polish with it after. Because again, I have to have nail polish on my nails so I can stop the biting. And I was reading the reviews, and a lot of people said, hey, you can use this with regular nail polish. All you have to do is put the top gel coat and cure it. And I thought, okay. So once I soaked off the strips, took it out, and I show pictures of how I did that as well. And I just did the usual Nail Tech 2, the Chip Skip Nail Tech 2, did my Muppets, and then another thing, because one reviewer said you really have to have the paint dry, I ran it through the LED light for 30 seconds, not the 60. I did the 60 seconds on the top coat, but once I put in the base on both hands, dry. I did my one coat of Wonka, was dry as a bone, did the Excusez-moi, did that, dry as a bone, and then did the top coat, and cured it for 60 seconds. The one thing, though, is it could have been shinier, and the reason why it's not as shiny is I had used up all the alcohol, I used up the two alcohol pads, and I have no rubbing alcohol at home. So I was like, as I'm curing the thing, I'm like on my iPhone, like, how do you take off the sticky stuff? Because it does, when you cure it with the gel top coat, the alcohol, so you have to put the alcohol, you have to swipe your nails before you put on the strips, and then once you cure it with the gel coat, you then have to take, there's a sticky residue, so you take it off with the alcohol pads, and it's shiny and beautiful. Let me blubber it more about how shiny it was. I was impressed with the shine. But I used it all up and I had no rubbing alcohol. So I'm looking it up. I'm figuring it out. And then I remembered someone saying that they use sanitizer pads. You know, the wipes that was pure alcohol. I'm like, okay, I don't have that. But I have a hand sanitizer. So I look. It's the Bath & Body Works. And it was the second ingredient. Not the first. If it was the first ingredient, it could have worked. But it was the second ingredient. The first ingredient was water. But I took a little bit of it, rubbed it on each one, and it got the residue off, but it's not as shiny. So that's the one thing I'm going to be getting today when I go grocery shopping, is getting rubbing alcohol, because it's so shiny. My test this morning was washing the dishes without my gloves, and it lasted. I'm cleaning tomorrow. We'll see how that goes. I'm not going to be putting on my gloves. I'm going to see if, so next episode, if I still have my Muppet nail polish, then it was gold. Because even though the soaking and the taking it off was simple, it's a lot more effort than just going in and just wiping it off with nail polish remover. So it's a process. So it's easy enough for me to be okay with it, but not so easy that I can just quickly do it. So we're going to see how this goes. And you're not, so the one thing is, you are not supposed to peel off gels. Like, you're not really supposed to peel off regular nail polish anyway, because it still ruins the nail. But if you, and I've done it before, and I know it from experience, that if you peel off gels, it's really bad. I don't know if this is the case with, since it's regular nail polish with the gel, but I don't care. I'm not risking it, because it just kills your nails. It kills them. You are not supposed to peel them. You're supposed to soak them off. So, and gently scrape it off with a cuticle. Like, it's supposed to come off. And that was the best thing about the strips. They incinerated in my little foily thing. So it was very easy to come off. So, but not too easy that I'm willing to wait through that again tonight. These are on my nails for another week if it stays. So we'll see how that goes. And I'm also thinking, because I really think that it would help my nails a lot if I kept, if I wanted to keep doing the week on week, having that gel cover, so that way it's staying good, it's staying true, but then I can still do the fun week thing of, ooh, pretty nail art, you know? And that's the one thing people have said, is if you just do the basic gel manicure and have it sheer, and then you can stamp over things, you can glitterize it, and then just take it off with non-acetone. And it's fine, it keeps the gel. So we'll be doing that. So that is my review. We are almost at an hour, and I had a wish list ready for you guys, but I think my news is going to have to come before my wish list. So I'm sorry, you guys. I had a wish list ready for you. I actually had the best, but it's going to have to wait, because it's already 59 minutes. So I want to get this news out. So I'm going to be doing another giveaway. I'm going to be doing multiple giveaways. because Alicia from Purple Goddess Design is the best woman ever, best person ever. And we've been talking back and forth about doing giveaways, but she's amazing. So let me pull. Well, first let me just show you what. So this is mine. No one's allowed these. Mine. I'm sorry. I'm so greedy. These are mine. Maybe. I'm trying to decide if I want to give one away and keep the other, but screw it. I love them. They're mine. We'll see. If the first giveaway goes well, then maybe. But the color is... Oh, no, they're different. Oh. Okay, no, I do have to give away. Okay. So one is pink and blue shock, and stuff a sock in it. Her base stuff a sock in it, which is the usual 80-20. I thought they were the same. Oh my gosh. Well, maybe I want to keep one. No. So, I don't know. I have to decide. Anyway, we're going to have multiple giveaways. So this is pink and blue sky. Pink and blue shock. This is electric shock. I thought they were both electric shock. They're both in the stuff a sock in it. I want the electric shock. Yes, I do. Because look at that sparkles. I'm keeping this no matter what. This is mine. And it's a good yardage. It's about 400 yards, 100 grams. So this would be an easy sock. Same goes for this one. So let me show you this again. They look the same, but they're gorgeous. I guess this has more pink. Oh, no spreckles. Okay. All right. Okay. Oh, quick note. If you hear more background noise, I'm really sorry, but it's 80 degrees here, and I have the windows open, and I have to keep the door open. I usually keep, to minimize my parakeet sounds, I've been closing my bedroom door. But it's not going to fly. It's too hot. I don't hear them, though. So I'm a little nervous. So I'm going to have to check on them. So I showed her in my wish list before. And she does stitch markers and she does baked goods. Love baked goods. But baked goods are not really good to give away because eventually, you know, they have to be eaten right away. So, but she has stitch markers. I'm sorry. I'm keeping the rainbow one. These are very nice and they're perfect for shawl knitting. And they don't have anything to catch on it. It's very nice. It's very pretty. And look at the bag. Her wrapping is just amazing. New card, Purple Goddess Designs. So that's mine. But I'm going to give away these ones. Oh my gosh. So this is a good amount. Like, look. See, you get a really good amount of stitch markers. So this is going to be given away. Okay? That will be given away. And then here's some yarn for you. Here's some more yarn. This is called Deep Purple Fog in Stuff a Sock in It. And it's a very nice. So I think I'm going to. So it's going to be three giveaways. It hurts my heart. Because I want to keep it all. I really do want to keep it all. But the intention is to give it away. So, because everyone, not just me, needs to love the Purple Goddess Designs. Because I love her. I haven't had her baking goods, which I think I'm gonna have to. But her stitch markers are amazing. Her color theory is amazing. Her color theory, like, look at this beautiful purple. It has depth to it. Like, it kind of looks bluish in the camera, but there you go. See that depth of purple? It's a very nice, I would call it a royal purple. And it's just so soft. So soft. So, yeah. Dude, I could seriously buy a sweater's quantity of this color and make a sweater. That's a thought. That is a thought. I'm not allowed to buy anymore. So I'm not allowed to buy any more yarn. So, but it's an idea. Alicia, it's an idea. Anyway, sorry. It's beautiful. I just keep showing this because it's beautiful. So, now, our forearms are not as active. So, but if she's amazing. And if I do enough advertising and I get all my TFIM peers over. So I'm going to open 3 separate threads, either Saturday night when this episode is up or later on, for each one with a question. And then I will draw this not next week, but I'm going to give you guys 2 weeks to enter into this. And then we'll see. And of course, do your random number generator and get it out there. So in 2 weeks. So today's June 1st. So the third Saturday of June. Okay? Which I think is the 15th. Yeah, the 15th. So you have until the 15th to enter in, put in your answers, and yeah, you could either win the amazing stitch muckles. See, look at that amazingness. It's a little bag. Or you could get the amazing pink and blue shock. Or deep purple fog, which, seriously, I kind of want it in sweater quantities. I'm going to have to write this down. It's gorgeous. So, yep, that is my huge news, and I really, 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 really hope that, there's going to be some competition. So I do not want to just give it to one person. So, and I'll think up some, I may just end up asking, what are you going to knit with this? Or, what's your favorite color? I don't know. I'll think of something. But anyway, that is my huge news. And I hope, if this gets a good amount of attention, and I can get this out to people, and I get enough people discussing in the Ravelry, I may then do something that I have been talking with other people about. I'm not allowed to talk about it. I put up my firstborn child not to talk about this, but it all hinges on getting more people to be involved in the Ravelry group. So, yeah. Anyway, all right, I better cut this off because this is now a full hour and I still have to go grocery shopping and whatnot. So I, sorry for the blabber, but I hope this review helped I hope my review of Sally Hansen helped. And I thank you again for watching with me. And I look forward to seeing you guys again. You can find me at Twitter, J_crafty_geek. You can find me at Instagram at jcraftygeek, no underscores. You can find me on Ravelry as Knitterly Book Goddess. And we have, a Ravelry group, so check us out. Anyway, I will see you later. And have a great nitty ditty day. Bye.
But I don't care for sugar, honey, if I can't have